Dear students, welcome to the video lecture series. Now in this series lecture, we are going to discuss today concept of transistor biasing. This lecture is created and narrated by Hemant Satpute, teacher, Department of Electronic Science, Fergusson College, Junior Wing, Pune. In this lecture number one, we will be learning or we will be discussing meaning of the term transistor biasing, exact meaning of the term proper zero signal collector current IC, exact meaning of the term proper minimum base to emitter voltage VBE, exact meaning of the term proper minimum collector to emitter voltage, and exact meaning of the term stabilization. Remember, all these terms are used again and again regarding transistor biasing. So this lecture specially devotes a time in understanding the meaning, exact meaning of these terms. So let's begin. Let us see what is the meaning of transistor biasing. The main function of a transistor is to do amplification. The weak signal is applied to the base of the transistor and amplified output is obtained in the collector circuit. This increase in the magnitude of the signal without any change in shape is known as faithful amplification. To achieve this, input circuit, that is base emitter junction of the transistor, must remain forward biased, and output circuit, that is the collector base junction, must remain reverse biased during all parts of the signal. This is known as biasing. Thus, to achieve faithful application, the following three conditions must be satisfied. Number one, proper zero signal collector current, minimum proper base to emitter voltage at any instant, minimum proper collector to emitter voltage VCE at any instant. The conditions 1 and 2 ensures that the base emitter junction shall remain properly forward biased during all parts of the signal, while condition 3 ensures that base collector junction shall remain properly reverse biased at all times. Let us see the meaning proper zero signal collector current. Consider an NPN transistor as shown in figure A. During positive half cycle of the signal, base emitter junction is forward biased. This gives base current and larger collector current to flow in the circuit. Thus, positive half cycle gets amplified in the collector as shown. Here it has been shown positive half cycle will get amplified. However, during negative half cycle of the signal, the base emitter junction is reverse biased and hence no current flows in the circuit. Thus, there is no output during the negative half cycle of the signal. And therefore, this will give an amplified output of the signal with its negative half cycle completely cut off, which is unfaithful application. Which is unfaithful amplification. Now, introduce a battery source VBB as shown in figure B. When no signal is applied, a DC current IC will flow in the collector circuit due to this VBB. This is known as zero signal collector current. When signal voltage is applied, the forward bias on emitter base junction increases. Therefore, base current increases, which further increases the collector current. During negative half cycle, base current reduces because base is positive with respect to emitter, so that the collector current also reduces. Hence, voltage drop across collector increases. So, the AC collector current IC due to the signal is now IC plus capital IC. This IC is the current flowing through the collector due to the applied input signal, and this capital I with suffix C is the DC collector current. So to achieve faithful amplifications, proper zero signal collector current must flow. The value of zero signal collector current should be greater than or equal to maximum collector current due to the signal alone. Now this situation is indicated in the diagram. Next, let us learn the meaning of proper minimum base to emitter voltage, VBE. The base current is very small until the input voltage overcomes the potential barrier at the base emitter junction. The value of this potential barrier is 0.5 volt for germanium transistors and 0.7 volt for silicon transistors. Now, once the potential barrier is overcome, the base current and hence collector current increases sharply. Thus, to get faithful amplification, VBE should not fall below these specified values. Here, the forward characteristics graphs of the base emitter diode has been shown. So, it's a graph of IB against VBE for germanium diode and for silicon diodes. Now, let us learn the meaning of the third term, proper minimum value of VCE, collector to emitter voltage. When VCE is too low, less than 0.5 volt for germanium and 1 volt for silicon transistors, the collector base junction is not properly reverse biased. Therefore, the collector cannot attract the charge carriers emitted by the emitter. So, this decreases the collector current while the base current increases. So, this will result in unfaithful amplification. So that to get faithful amplification, collector to emitter voltage VCE should not fall below 0.5 volt for germanium transistor and 1 volt for silicon transistor. This is called as knee voltage. Inherent variations of transistor parameters such as beta, VBE may change the operating point, resulting in unfaithful application. So, it is essential to make operating point independent of transistor parameters. Let us now learn the next term, that is known as stabilization. The collector current in transistor changes rapidly when the temperature changes and the transistor is replaced by another of the same type. This is due to inherent variations of transistor parameters. Now, due to these changes, operating point gets changed. Thus, the process of making operating point independent of temperature changes or variation in transistor parameters is known as stabilization. So, please remember this definition. I repeat, the process of making operating point independent of temperature changes or variation in transistor parameters is known as stabilization. Once stabilization is done, the zero signal collector current IC and collector to emitter voltage VCE becomes independent of temperature variations or replacement of transistor. That is, the operating point remains fixed. So, biasing network associated with the transistor must ensure the stabilization of operating point. I hope you have understood the concept. Now, that's all for today. Stay tuned for the next video lecture in the series. Please do visit our YouTube video channel FYJC Vocational Electronics for all the video lectures in this series. Subscribe, like, share, and stay tuned.